Vancouver, Mount Pleasant.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Thank you, Honourable Speaker. For years, we've been calling on this government to close a loophole that is forcing renters to choose between paying a huge increase in their rent or find a new place to live. Yesterday, the Premier said she believes people should have the opportunity to wake up in a place that they can call their own, to raise their children in a place that they know they don't have to move at the end of every month. I agree, Honourable Speaker. But the Premier refuses to close the loophole, and as a result, renters are forced to move out of their homes because they can't afford the rental hikes. Lindsay Arbader is a renter in Vancouver whose landlord exploits the fixed-term leases. Her rent has gone up nearly 10% in the last 2 years. Lindsay feels like she is being squeezed out of her home because of the law that the BC Liberals refuse to change. Honourable Speaker, my question is to the Housing Minister. Why hasn't he closed the loophole to protect renters like Lindsay?
Minister responsible for housing.
Fixed-term tenancy has been in place in British Columbia about 40 years, so you had 10 years to take a look at this and you did nothing with it. We have done some work to try and see how we can do it, at the same time protect the property, the rights of people that want to come into British Columbia for short-term tenancies, some of people that in the movie industry that come in and do a one-year lease and then move on. There are issues legally that are being worked on with that, and we're doing the work right now, Honourable Member. But I heard the member say that she, what the Premier said yesterday about people having the opportunity to own their own home and know that they can make a mortgage payment and not get moved out every day. And she says she supports that when in actual fact you've clearly stated publicly that you will not keep the home program, you will cancel it and not have affordable homeownership for people in British Columbia who want to buy their first home. So explain that to me somehow, how you balance the fact that you absolutely don't. And the member for Coquitlam goes like this, oh, by the way, there's 60 people approved to buy their first home in the Tri-Cities on the Lower Mainland of British Columbia alone.
All comments will be directed through the chair. Vancouver, Mount Pleasant.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Bakos Malay is a renter in Vancouver who was handed a 20% increase in his rent because he was on a fixed-term lease. The legal limit for a rent increase is 2.9%. He couldn't afford this huge spike in his rent, so he had to find somewhere else to live. Honourable Speaker, the issue with fixed-term leases isn't just happening in Vancouver. 80% of the leases in Kitimat are fixed-term. If the Premier really thinks people shouldn't have to move out of their homes at the end of every month, then why is this government allowing landlords to increase rents by 20% for people like Bakos?
Minister responsible for housing.
Thank you, Madam. Well, Madam Speaker, as I said, we're doing some work on it because there's significant legal issues and stuff that needs to be worked out with regards to rights of people in a fixed-term tenancy that's a legal binding agreement between two parties. Outside of that, anybody that is actually operating under the Residential Tenancy Act should not be raising their rents any more than 2% plus CPI, because that is the law. And I know you don't like that. However, this member in particular should be very thankful to the government of British Columbia, given the fact that we bought 24 buildings in your riding, renovated and saved them for affordable housing in your community. Of them province-wide, buildings that we renovated and added into the marketplace for actually for affordability. Tens of thousands of units since 2001 have been built in British Columbia affordable housing. The number of shelter spaces with meals in British Columbia is three times the number of shelter spaces in 2001. But remember this, in 2001 there wasn't a shelter in British Columbia that was open 24 hours a day with meals for people instead of throwing them out on the street. There were no outreach workers dealing with the homeless and people with the most at risk in this province of British Columbia. This is the most significant, successful housing strategy in Canadian history. We continue to have pressures that we'll deal with. Our important part, the most important
Members.
Part of this for us is that we...
Thank you, Minister.
Madam Speaker, the most vulnerable in British Columbia have been where we're concentrating the money as we also do other things for affordable rental in British Columbia. And the NDP at some point in time are going to have to tell the province of British Columbia's people why they would cancel a safer and rent assistance program to help people that are vulnerable because you don't support that program, and why you will cancel a program that will help families get into their first home for the first time in their lives. You'll cancel that. And in canceling that, you'll also notionally actually not bring in the rental housing additions that you
Thank
build
you,
by changing the marketplace.